Before this video starts, we have made a mistake. We have videoed the full video with our new camera, new mics, to edit on our new laptop, and we forgot to plug the mic into the new camera. So even though I had it on the whole time, it wasn't actually recording. So the whole footage is using the built-in microphone in the camera. Apologies in advance. Hope you enjoy the video. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you at the end. Also, forgot to add, the hoodie competition we did went down really well. So because it went so well, we're going to do it again on this video. All you've got to do is comment, whatever the comment is, leave your full name and the word competition, and we will reveal the winner on the next video. The only stipulation is you have to be in the UK, because I can't be shipping 30 quid jumper to the other side of the world. And if it's still proving to be a good little concept, we will keep it rolling each video. Well, everyone, welcome back to the channel. We are back in the CLK that we did the buyer's guide on a few weeks back. We discovered we had an oil leak from the rocker cover gaskets, oil filter housing and cooler. So today we're going to get that done. Really common job on the M113 engine. So let's get into it. CLK M113 oil leak. We had a leak from the breather boxes, the rocker covers, and we've got a leak coming from underneath this. So we're going to get one bank done, oil filter housing done, just to show you what goes on. Okay, right, first thing we're going to do is we're going to get the coil packs off and out of our way, because they're in the way. I have a special tool for popping off the coil pack leads, so that goes behind the plug. Right, just keep it rolling. Right. You ready?
Just ready whenever you are.
That's what you get for showing off with your new tool. Just gonna mark these up which cylinder they came from, because I'm gonna just move them out of my way. Just gonna have to remove the fuel pipe to the fuel rail, so we're just gonna take the fuel cap off just to release the pressure out of the tank so it doesn't squirt out and last thing we want to petrol in our eyes. Right, so we've got the fuel pipe out of the way. I've just got some rags to let the excess fuel drip into that. In the meantime, I'm going to start undoing all the rocker cover bolts. Pretty much ready to take the rocker off. One rocker cover. So now we've got to separate this part from this part. You can see the sealant there. Feels quite soft. I was expecting it to be quite hard, but it's not. So I suspect this has probably been done before. Now we've got it off, you can probably see better where it's been leaking from, which is around this seal. So we're gonna remove this top breather cover, clean everything up. That is on with sealant, there's no gasket, unfortunately. And then we will put it all back together, and then that's one side done. Okay, one breather box. Now I've got to get off all the old silicone which is a bit of a pain really, scraping it all off and getting it all clean. Then we can reseat the new one on top, lightly torque it in, and then, because it's actually held on by three of those three hold it in position, and then they go through it, which clamp it all together as well. We've got all the sealant off the best we can. Obviously it's all stuck in these bits. You've got to take your time getting it out really. I've got a little bucket of kerosene which we're just going to use to clean these up. We may as well make them look nice before we put them back on. Right, we've cleaned up the rockers, dried them all off, brake cleaners, bone dry. Just gonna clean up the bolts. To clean up the bolts, I'm just gonna, to get all that off, I'm just gonna run it through a little tap. Oh, it's not actually a tap, it's a die. All surfaces perfectly clean and dry. We've got genuine Mercedes sealant. Right, all the silicone is, well, sealant really. This job requires patience. It actually takes longer to prepare it all than it does to do the job, I think. When you're doing up these three T25s, they're not tight, purely to just hold it in place whilst you place your rocker cover on, because obviously your big bolts that go through hold it on. So that's all secure. I'm just gonna leave that for a couple of minutes. Gasket's on. I've just rubbed a bit of grease all over it to allow it to slide a bit while I'm putting the bolts in, because the last thing we want to do is drag the gasket off. So I find that a lot easier. Rocker's back on, bolts back in, and then we can start torquing it down. Quick problem, the breather pipe that goes onto the breather box is split. The pipe's really hard and gone brittle, so it's cracked. So we need to order two of those, one for each side. It is a bit of a while you're in there job. It's no one's fault, it's just rock hard. But these are the things we come across. Fuel pipe going back on. Don't tighten up one end, do them both loose. And then tighten them both up together so you've got a bit of movement. Check that again. Last thing we want is a massive fuel leak all over your manifold. Just a nice fire. Just chucking a bit of coil pack grease and the coil pack's ready for going back on. Right, so we've labelled them up so we know where they came from. That's not because you can't interchange where coil packs come from, you can. It's because on this engine, these leads are a specific length for each cylinder, so we know where they come from. When you buy these individually, you buy them specifically for a cylinder. But normally, if I was taking coil packs off, I wouldn't label them. When you push it on, you want to have a nice, good click. If you don't, it's not on properly. Whilst we're on the topic of labelling coil packs, when I was an apprentice, I was doing a set of plugs on a V12, and I was always taught to do that, so I did it. I was obviously 16, 17. The customer came back and complained that I had put little dots on his coil packs, and he had to bring the car back, and I had to stand there and scrape off each spot. Obviously it comes off easy enough, it's like a Tipex, and I had to scrape off each one, and he was not happy at all. There you go, a little story for you. Right, that's one side done. Nice and clean. I think you can see the difference to the side we haven't done. We'll move on to the oil cooler job. We're not going to do the driver's side on camera because it's exactly the same job as the other side. So we'll move on to the oil cooler. And Nathan can do the opposite side. Now I've shown him what to do. Who's holding the camera? Some people say you can't put that back in. But we are.
Brand new.
Brand new. Right, so we've got a gigantic nut at the bottom of that. I think it's like a 56 or 58 from memory. T30s in the back of the cooler. So we need to separate that from that and then we can get that out. Right, we've undone the four little screws. That's enabled us to pull that back. So now we need to get this out. Big ratchet. It's 46 mil. Not very often to use this. It's fully not required, but thought I'd use it. Like a big lollipop. There we go. So what's causing the problem is this seal here and this seal here, see how they're flat. They should be proud of it to make a seat, and the main cause of the issue is this one. That is gone really hard and brittle, so the new one should be a bit thicker and a bit softer so we get a nice. Right, back to the wash bucket. Three new seals. I am gonna put a load of grease on them to keep them soft. Makes it a bit easier to install as well. Filter housing's all cleaned up. So we've cleaned our nut off before we put it in.
Sounded like I was making a brew then.
Torque setting is 70 newton meters. Confirm. Just gonna put that in so there's no risk of anything going in. Getting my bolts back in. And then there's one more seal to replace, which is a little sneaky one, which not many people do. But it's definitely a while you're in there job. It's difficult to see as well, so we'll try our best. Put my filter back in.
Click, click.
Last job. So that is the last job. There's a seal behind there with two bolts. That is common for leaking. We'll get it out and show you, and it's definitely worth doing while you're in there. Because of the mess it makes, you can't really tell if it's leaking or not, because everything's from the top and obviously gravity takes over. So let's get it out.
That was a flattering angle, that.
I've done it. That's the last one. That is where you take an oil pressure feed from. That's the gasket. Well worth doing. We'll give it a wash. Right, that's all done. Only the other side to do, which we're going to do off camera because same process. But what we are going to do is we're not going to start the car, we're going to leave it overnight to let that sealant settle, and we're going to get some new breather pipes as well. Right, we've got the new pipes. We gotta fit them. Goes from there, connects just under there. Also replacing this one. It goes from here down to the back underneath the airflow sensor. Nathan's doing the other rocker cover, and we've got this part to replace as well, from there just under there. Finally, you can see everything back together, both rockers on, all the breather pipes replaced. Here are the old ones that were removed. Time to get the airbox back on. Covers up all our good work so you can't see a thing. As always, we're going to finish off cleaning it with toolbox cleaner. You can get your products off them using our discount code for 15% off. This time we're doing a two-stage detail, which we finish off with the Lumen product, which gives it a nice shine to finish off with. Here you can see a nice glossy finish. Definitely recommend these products, guys, especially with the discount. I've been using it for years now. It's really good stuff. Right, I hope you made it to the end. Again, apologies for the bad audio. We are going to try our best to keep bringing footage. I wanted to do one a week, but it's proving really difficult. So thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Next video, we're definitely going to remember to put the cameras on.